Hello and welcome to The Debrief. Happy International Women's Day. To celebrate, we are joined by an excellent panel and we're going to discuss International Women's Day and the theme of this year's International Women's Day, which is progress. What does it mean? How do we achieve it? And how do we even know if we are achieving it?
I think it's vital that we recognise how far we've come in the fight for gender equality, which, you know, in the UK in particular, we're celebrating 100 years since women, well, since some women first got the right to vote. And that's great, but also we need to use it as an opportunity to see how far we still have to go. And, you know, one of the things I always think is fun about International Women's Day is it's also the day that the phrase International Men's Day is the most Googled.
I think, like, progress as well, especially if you're going somewhere and you're trying to create progress, you have to be able to stop and check where you've come from, where you're going. I think that's really important. I think we all do that with work, with life, with relationships and everything. So I think this is a just really great moment to pause and look how far we can go. And also it's just great because everyone feels so positive on this day, don't we?
Women are paying attention to other women on this day as well, and that it is a movement which actually looks at those that are more disadvantaged. So we reckon in the UK there's more than a million women, young women, struggling and really not knowing where the next meal's going to come from, and wanting to put food on the table or going to food banks. And so I think it's also a good day to stop and celebrate how we've moved on and from our grandmothers' generations, but also to say we mustn't forget those women who are still hugely disadvantaged in our society.
It's kind of nebulous, and is it equality within our current system, which is grounded in, how can we achieve equality in a system that is grounded in inequality? So I think we have to actually look at the system in which we're operating in. Is this the system that we want to achieve equality in? Because that will not be equality for everybody.
The complacency is one of the things that I think is the biggest threats that we have here. You know, the number of, companies, for example, that will talk about how, well, you know, they don't have very many women at the top currently, but it's going to be okay because if they look at the women they've got coming into the organisation, it's 50-50, or in some cases it's more than 50%. But you look at something like, I don't know, law firms, they've had more than 50% intake being women for more than 20 years. And yet, even if you look at the people who are currently being promoted to partner or in the kind of court system who are becoming silks QCs, which typically takes about 15 years or so, you know, they are sort of three quarters men. So so there's sometimes this sort of, well, it will all sort itself out in time. And no, actually, gender equality doesn't happen by accident. In fact, no kind of equality happens by accident. If you just leave things to the default, then the people who have power will continue hoarding that power and things won't change.
I think there are lots of little steps we can take, which means that the worldview will change gradually. Absolutely. Too, yeah. And then people's expectations. You know, I grew up thinking all politicians look more like Tony Blair than Joe Swinson. I am delighted that Joe Swinson is here and sets a different image for my children about who can be an MP.
I think we very, very rarely think about, or not think about, but talk about and act on things that don't directly affect us. I know that's true, and I think we should all check ourselves on that. I think that's really important.
Yeah, I agree. I think we need to check ourselves, because if it was women, we're not thinking about other women, then
what are we doing it for?
You know, that kind of concerns me, and I talk to a lot of young women.
There's a calling out culture at the moment that is very much, I mean, it's been necessary to identify lots of these completely like toxic processes that have been incredibly oppressive to many of us for centuries. But I think now they're especially kind of encouraged, inflamed by social media. Kind of mob-like, can become a mob-like mentality to call people out. I think also there's certain conversations where I'm just like, there is no progress happening in this conversation. People are just becoming more polarized and entrenched in their oppositional position. So I think calling people in could maybe be an antidote.
I love that. That's brilliant.
Great. Well, thanks for coming. Thanks for listening. And thank you all very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah. Good to chat.